In this video, I'll be talking about Gauss's lemma, and we are going to prove this theorem that shows that the legendary symbol value a by p, this is equal to minus 1 to the power n. And what is n? So before I explain the term, let's consider p to be an odd prime and GCD of a comma b is equal to 1. Then this will hold where n denotes the number of integers in the set s equal to multiples of a, and we need to take first p minus 1 by 2 multiples of a. And to count n, so n denotes the number of integers in the set S whose remainder upon division by p exceed p by 2. Let's take an example before we proceed to the proof of this theorem. Let us consider an example. In this case, let me to choose any integer. Let's first choose a prime number. Let's consider p as 13. And let us choose any integers whose GCD with this prime number is 1. So let us take a is equal to 5. And then I want to consider, to construct the set, I want to consider multiples of 5, first p minus 1 multiples, p minus 1 by 2 multiples. What is p minus 1 by 2 in this case? This is 13 minus 1 by 2, that is 6. So this means I need to consider first 6 multiples. So that means 2 into 5, then I get 3 into 5, 4 into 5, 5 into 5, and I need to take last quantity is x, 6 into y. The set is actually 5, 10, 15, 20, 25 and 30. Now this set, in this set I want to check the numbers whose remainder upon division by p. So now I want to find out the remainder with respect to modulo, in this case because p is 13, so I want to see which are, what are the remainder in this case. It is already smaller quantity 5 and 10, but 15 with respect to modulo 13 is actually 2. In the similar way, 2 is congruent to 7, 25, this is congruent to 12, and 30, this is congruent to 4. So now these are the remainders, or I can say these are the reduced class. Let's count how many remainders exceed p by 2. P by 2, and in this case p by 2 is 13 by 2. So that means remainder value should be greater than 13 by 2 is 6.5. So the remainder value should be at least greater than or equal to 7, in case, because we want to check it in the integral form. So greater than 7 is this one, 12 and 10. So there are three numbers whose remainder exceed 7. And in this case, the formula says that a by p is equal to minus 1 to the power 3. There are three numbers whose remainder exceed this quantity p by 2. And in this case, it is minus 1 to the power odd. So this quantity is minus 1. This means it allows me to know that 5 by p, and in this case 5 by 13, so this means 5 is quadratic non-residue, because the value of the legendary symbol is minus 1, and if the value of the legendary symbol is minus 1, it talks about quadratic non-residue. There are only two possibility of the legendary symbol: either it can take the value plus 1 or it can take the value minus 1. Now let's see the proof of the theorem. In the proof, we have already taken that GCD of a comma p is equal to 1. So this means the element in the set, that is we have taken in the theorem, that is a, 2a, 3a, and we have considered up till p minus 1 by 2 multiples of a. So we can simply say that, so none of this quantity is congruent to 0, as we have already seen in the example also. You can see here that this, none of these value is a 0. But how do we prove this in the case of, and we cannot take a equal to 0. The only possibility, because we have considered about a prime. You see here in the theorem, we have considered for a prime. Prime is never 0. We cannot take a also equal to 0, because if we take a is equal to 0, then the GCD will not be 1. So that means the first condition is clear, that a and b are non-zero. So that proves our this condition, that already justify our first condition, that none of the p minus 1 integers in the set is congruent to 0. So let's say if some j time a is congruent to 0 modulo p. In this case, because it is a prime, so this implies either j is congruent to 0 modulo p or a is congruent to 0 modulo p. This means p divides a, this condition, but that's not possible. This is not possible because the GCD of a and p is equal to 1. This is also not possible. This is also not possible. Why this is not possible? Because the possibility of j is lying between 1 to p minus 1 by 2. As we can see, I have considered here the j as 1, 2, 3. The value of j varies between 1 to p minus 1. So none of the cases is possible. So this means none of the integer in the set that we have considered is congruent to 0. And the second condition we say none of elements of S are congruent to each other. If they are congruent to each other, we can again see what will happen. Because if they are congruent, let's consider there is some R times A. This is congruent to S times A modulo P. And we know that R and S lies between P minus 1 by 2. In this case, because A and P have the GCD as 1. So using the cancellation law in the congruence classes, I can cancel this. Means S is congruent to R is congruent to S modulo P, which is not possible. This is also not possible because the values of R and S lie between 1 and P minus 1. So P cannot divide it the smaller value. So two results are little obvious. None of the P minus 1 by 2 in the set is congruent to 0 and none of them are congruent to each other. So we may say that S, which is this quantity A, 2A, up till so on, P minus 1 by 2 times A. This is congruent to some numbers, that is A1, A2, up till so on, A times P minus 1 by 2. And these AIs are, of course, strictly greater than 0 and they are smaller than this quantity P, because we are considering this with respect to modulo P. So we can relate this quantity in the example as we have seen that we have considered 5 multiple of 5. We have considered 6 multiples of 5 and the set elements are smaller than 13. So you can see that these AIs are going to take one or the other form of this. Of course, they are not all numbers because we are calculating the reduced class calculate the numbers lying between 0 to P minus 1. So that we are not considering, but these are the number. And the set must be congruent to this set modulo P. Now, in this set, consider the numbers whose remainder is strictly less than P by 2. So now consider that if we divide this set by P further, so these are the remainder is divisible by P. So I'm rewriting now the star set considering those number whose remainder is strictly less than P by 2. So I rename them into R1, R2 up till Rm. So in the example, we can see here whose number is less than P by 2. So less than P by 2 is 2, less than P by 2 is 4, says 5. But there are some number whose remainder is greater than. So in this case, because this P is 13, and if P is 13, then P by 2 we have considered it as 13 by 2. So the remainder should be greater than or equal to 7 at least. So I'm renaming those integers whose remainder is greater than P by 2 as, so let S1, S2 up till be those remainders such that Si's remainders are strictly greater than P by 2 and it is less than P. And by the total count we know, so M plus N. So there are some remainder here in the first set and there are some number here in the set. In fact, they are the renaming of the set element in the star. And in this case, I wanted to add the total number. That number should be definitely P minus 1 by 2. So these are M plus N equal to P minus 1 by 2. And if I notice now that the numbers R1, R2, these remainders, and the remainder when I subtracted this from the main prime, these are all positive. And less than P by 2. So let us see why these are. R1, R2, Rm, they are already. So in this case, in the example, what is R1, R2? R1, R2 were the remainders which are smaller than P by 2. So what were the smaller than P by 2? Smaller than P by 2 was 2, 5 and 4. But the number S1, S2, S3 which were greater than P by 2, these are 7, 12 and 10. And let me to subtract now in this case, if I take P minus S1. So this means 10 will become 13 minus 10, this is 3. 13 minus 7, this will become 6. 13 minus 12, this will become 1. Now, notice here that these numbers, the remainders are less than P by 2 definitely, but they are also incongruent to the previous set. Okay, none of these elements are congruent to each other. So, we have claimed that they are positive integers and less than P by 2. And none of them are congruent to each other. On contrary, we can take that these quantities are congruent to each other. Say, suppose if I consider that sum of the P minus si is congruent to rj. They are same. Okay. If they are same, they are congruent, because we have already said that these quantities are less than p by 2. So if they are same, but noticing that why this p minus si come? P minus si comes actually from this set sj's, and ri's are the element which are here that have been come up from this set. But this set is the renaming of a1, a2 up till this set, which we have considered in star, and the star is congruent to the multiples of a. So this means that we can write down si is congruent to ua modulo p. Similarly, rj is congruent to v times a modulo p. So we can see from here that p is si plus rj, which means p is the value of si plus rj. We can substitute here and we can write down this value as, so u plus v times a is congruent to si plus rj. So this is the value that we have just got it from here, if we simply add these two congruences. But this is further equal to p, and p is congruent to 0 mod p. Okay, so this may, and we know that the GCD of a and p is, this GCD is 1, GCD of a and p is equal to 1. So the only possibility it allow is that u plus v should be congruent to 0 mod p. But that's not the case. Why? Because individually, if I look at from here, the multiple of u, what is the possibility of the u? U lie between p minus 1 by 2. What is the possibility for v? V also lies between this. If I simply add these to u plus v, the maximum bound I can get is p minus 1. Okay, that's the maximum bound I can get, p minus 1, but if I add the upper bound. So if, even if it is p minus 1 modulo p, p is larger and p minus 1 is smaller. So obviously, this quantity is not possible. It cannot divide the smaller quantity. So now we can see that once we show that, that this is not possible, and none of the integers are congruent to each other. And if I look at, back at the theorem step, we see there are total number of m elements here, and then there are total number of n elements here in this set. The total number of elements are m plus n, that is p minus 1 by 2, and none of them are congruent to each other. This means it is counting all those number 1, 2 up till p minus 1 by 2 in some order. So now this in some order is congruent to, this is congruent to r1, r2 up till so on rm, and p minus s1 up till p minus sn. Okay, so they are congruent to each other. Now let's take the product of this set. If I take the product of this set, because considering that we know that this quantity is integer, remember that p is an odd prime, so if it is odd, p minus 1 is an even, it will be divisible by 2. So this is actually an integral quantity, so I can take the factorial, because it covers all those number which are smaller than this. So I can take product of the element in the set as p minus 1 by 2 factorial. This is congruent to r1, r2 up till rm into p minus s1 up till so on p minus sn. This quantity is congruent to r1, r2 up till rm. We can note it down. This is p, this is congruent to 0 modulo p. So I am replacing now this quantity simply by minus sn. Of course, this all is going with respect to modulo p. So we can see minus 1 raised to power n, and this n is coming due to this quantity, and here the remainder was actually greater than p by 2. So let's rewrite now this quantity r1, r2 up till rm into s1 up till sn. And we have also seen that these quantities, these remainder were taken from the set which was multiple of A. So just replace this whole set by the multiples of the set A, that is A into 2A into up till P minus 1 by 2 times A. And that is modulo P. Now take out the A common from the each element. How many times A can come out? A can come out P minus 1 by 2. And inside the term which is remaining, that is P minus 1 by 2 factorial modulo P. We can cancel it out now from both sides, p minus 1 by 2 factorial, because the GCD of p minus 1 by 2 factorial and p, this GCD is certainly 1. Okay, so we can cancel it out both sides. That leaves the quantity 1 is congruent to minus 1 to the power n a to the power p minus 1 by 2 modulo p. This means now just multiply again both sides by minus 1 to the power n. If I multiply minus 1 to the power, this will become positive, and hence this means that this quantity I can replace it by Legendre symbol. We have already done that Legendre symbol is same as a to the power p minus 1 by 2 modulo p. So that I'm just using the replacement, and hence it is minus 1 to the power n modulo p. So we can, that proves our result that a by p is equal to minus 1 to the power n, and this n is due to the remainders which are greater than p by 2. So this is coming up from the set S.